This video is about time and attendance. We will show you how AMS access events can be used to create reports on the attendance of your staff. The video is split in two parts. In the first part, we will configure AMS to export the incoming and outgoing door events. In the second part, we show how this export can be used as an import for a time and attendance management tool. In this video, we will use PASSCHIP. Part 1. Export from AMS. Enable the export. In order to accurately calculate the working hours of personnel, we need to record both incoming and outgoing events. So we need a door type with both an outside and inside reader. This applies to the main entrance, which takes us from outside into the office building. The reader outside in will register the incoming events. So we click the time management checkbox here. Of course, the inside out is the reader that records the outgoing events. So here too, the time management checkbox. Let's test if it works. We ask the Roho staff to log in once as a test and log out again shortly after, so that we will have created a total of 8 door events. This is the default location where AMS will save the export data, C, Program Files, x86, Bosch Seeker Hate C Stema, Access Management System, Access Engine, AC, TExchange. The name of the export file is taccexcxp.txt. We open with Notepad, we see a semicolon-separated file with 7 columns. The first column is the date. Formatted in day, month, year format. The second column is the time of the event in hours and minutes with a trailing S. The third column represents the direction, 1 means incoming, 0 means outgoing. The fourth column is the person ID. The maximum length is longer than the contents. That declares the spaces and the double quotes. The fifth column is the card number as it is printed on the card. But with zeros for the facility code. The sixth column is the reader's ID and the seventh column is the reader's name. For cost center there is no representing data. We are not completely satisfied with this export. We would like to add a few columns, such as first name, last name and department. Furthermore, we want to get rid of the empty column cost center and finally we want to offer the export as a CSV and not as a TXT file. Modify the export. If we want to include the department column in our export, we need to check that the field contains data in the personal data of our Roho staff. It is not a mandatory field. The same goes for first name. If everything is in order, we can continue. So we are going to implement all these changes in our export, and for that we will have to make adjustments in the registry. To do this, we start the registration editor tool. Then we go down into the folder structure H, key local machine, software, WOW 6432 node, MECOS, SPS, default, TACCEXC. Here we find the keys that have to do with time and attendance. We open the value of the additionally exported person columns key. To change a long string here is quite difficult. So we copy the data to Notepad. So that we can make changes and additions more easily. First, let's get rid of the obsolete column cost center. We will add the values last name, first name, and department. They are all persons related values. Therefore, we start with persons. After the equal sign, we type the label. That is what is going to become the title line. Now that our columns are complete, we copy and paste the data back into the value of the additionally exported person columns key. The other thing we had to modify was the extension of the file name. That should become CSV instead of TXT. This can be changed in the key value of ACCEXP file. To make sure the registry is reloaded, we need to restart AMS completely. Also, the background processes. So we can reset the system or we choose the tool ACE process control that is on our desktop. Stop all processes with a push of a button. And when the list is empty, press Start to restart the processes. When all processes are green and some black, the restart is complete. And we can test the results of our changes. We ask the Roho employees again to log on and log off, and we check the results. So far, everything meets our requirements. The file is CSV, the cost center title is gone, and three new important columns have been added. Now that we have the exported data in the right format, we can bring it to the target application. Part 2. Import from PASSCHIP. Enable the import. This application runs on a web server and can be opened from an URL. It will be the first time that we are importing the data. So there is no basic information in the application. No cards. No readers. No employee groups. No schedules. And no employees. Let's start the import from AMS. We select the CSV file that we created in the previous chapter. The import did not take long and was successful. When importing, all relevant data fields in the system are now filled in, such as cards with their ID and linked to their owner. This also applies to the readers. They have a name and an ID. However, they are not linked to an area or a direction. That has to be configured in PASSCHIP itself. We do have employee groups. These come from the imported departments. And here we have our employees with all their details. But no work areas or schedules yet. Since we have not imported the areas and directions, we now need to configure this once in PASSCHIP. Therefore, we go to Reader History, and we will create the areas. We define the entry and the exit areas and add those to their corresponding readers, outside in and inside out. We have now re-established the connection between readers and the areas they lead us to. Now we need to tell the system what the work areas are. So where the presence of the employees can be counted. This can be multiple places, so we create a group all and the physical areas HQ and remote belong to it. Next we link the employee groups to the work areas. So these are all the departments that we imported earlier. Now all employees know their work areas. All means that attendance will be counted in areas HQ and remote. The last thing we need to configure in PASSCHIP is the working hours. Therefore we go to Schedules. We create a daily schedule from 9 o'clock till 17:30. We add the days, working and non-working hours to the timetable. The first working day is Monday. The employees are allowed to start between 8:45 and 9:15. And they are expected to leave between 17:15 and 17:45. Their working day should contain 8 hours and their duration leave 15 minutes. Of course, all employees are allowed a lunch break. That can take place in the time frame between 12 o'clock and 1400 hours PM and may last 30 minutes. So now we have all the colors. Red for no working time. Yellow for the buffer zone of entering and exiting. Blue for normal working time and green for lunch break. Now we copy the schedule from Monday to the remaining working days, until the working week is completely colored in. This is our full working week. During weekends and holidays, Rojo employees are not expected at work. On all other days, we would like to measure their attendance against the schedules. Therefore, the schedules need to be assigned to the users. This is done indirectly via the employee groups. Each group is assigned the newly created weekly schedule. Now we are complete. Each Rojo employee has now assigned the working areas and the working schedules. Based on the imported door events from AMS, we can start creating timely reports. The PASSCHIP export is done in XLSX format, which makes it easy to read with a spreadsheet like Excel. Each page shows detailed information about the attendance. This is the monthly overview. Here we can compare the normal work duration with the actual working time and as a result see the positive or negative overtime. For more details, you can open the daily page. There, the daily attendance per employee is displayed in rows. The reports from PASSCHIP are therefore quite detailed. And that is of course partly due to the data supplied by AMS, but also to everything we have added in the PASSCHIP configuration. In these reports everything comes together and the HR department can gain very accurate insight into the actual attendance of all the staff. This video was made possible by a contribution from PASSCHIP. PASSCHIP is a Romanian company that offers products and services in the field of access control. Both hardware and software. Time and attendance is one of their products. This was it for another new how-to video from AMS. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to be informed about new titles.